My name is Lane Sparber. I am a lighting designer and guitar and amp tech in Queens, New York. I grew up listening to the Beatles and Kiss. Those were the only two bands I listened to from age birth to 9 years old. Once I discovered Def Leppard's Pyromania album in 1983, as a nine-year-old, that's what made me want to play. And when I started playing, that's what made me want to fix. I grew up wanting to play punk rock and the blues and all these types of music that were very, very hard on my instruments. Being mechanically inclined, I started learning how to work on my own guitars rather than having to pay somebody else, which I couldn't do as often as I was breaking mine. Little by little, I learned how to work on the frets, how the electronics of the instrument worked, how to modify the electronics, how to modify the guitar, and sooner or later, it just turned into people asking me to do theirs for them. So I wanted to learn how the other half lived, so I started working on amps, guitar pedals, learning about basic electronics. This was pre-high school. Burning my hands a lot with a soldering iron, trying to figure out how to make it work and how to get things to last and if they would work and all this kind of stuff. And as I learned more and more about it, I was starting to repair my own amps and my own guitar pedals, and everything progressed from there. When you're playing a guitar, when you press your finger down on the string and that fret makes the note, the cleaner the fret is, the better the note's gonna sound. It's all about precision and cleanliness. Dirt hampers tone in any respect, be it in the amp, be it on the guitar. A dirty guitar is not gonna sound as good as a clean guitar. For working on instruments most of the time, you know, you get to put on your woodworking hat and get your wood file or your fret dressing equipment and just work on the instrument itself. And it's very zen. Working on the electronics side of amps and pedals can be a little more harrowing because guitarists still favor old technology tube amps, things like that, that have, you know, 400 to 600 volts in the amplifier, so you put your hand in the wrong place and that's your last repair. How we use the science to create the feel and the sound. It's not mojo, it's science, and it, you know, there's a procedure and a method to doing that when you're working on an amplifier. And my clients wind up friends, and I wind up liking their bands and buying their CDs and getting really into them. It's one of the best benefits of this, because I was a music fan first. I was a musician first, and thank heavens that's never really left me. I'm not going to be the next Eddie Van Halen, clearly, but I can maybe help the next Eddie Van Halen find a sound or keep him sounding great. That's the best thing for me. When I repair a piece of gear, it's almost like a little piece of me is up there performing with them. I work for a lot of Broadway musicians, and I'll go to Broadway shows, and there's nothing more fulfilling for me, not being the best player in the world, than seeing or hearing a guitar that was in pieces on my workbench the day before, rocking 2,000 people in a Broadway house and sounding killer. That's extremely fulfilling for me. We'll be right back.